that is what we see coming, where the regulator is defined and most important is the insurance part is covered. That is as far as regulations go. But what is more important for us today is, some of it has happened. Firstly is availability of testing facilities at competitive rates. I mark both availability of facility plus the rates at which it could be available to startups. Because the affordability for those tests, what we do for species, and especially for a nation industry in India, it is important that the rates for it also are defined. Here again, InSpace has created an excellent facility in Ahmedabad, but the aspirations of the startups would be, and like what we are doing in the study, is to see it as close as possible to where the startups are. So the aspirations would be looking at places like Bangalore, looking at Chennai, or at Hyderabad, where our industries are there, that they do not have to take equipment for testing all over the country. Because that itself will otherwise become a challenge for cost. Now, one very interesting thing, and which will continue, is making the user aware. Because we want to increase the market. And an example which NASSCOM has come out with is, in 2008, the Japanese, from demand-driven policy, they went into network-centric policy. And what was this network-centric policy was that making the users aware of where all space can be used. And this initiative in India was taken in 2017 by a Prime Minister himself, when he called all the ministries, all the secretaries, and asked them to look at how they would use space. And very recently now, this initiative is again being carried forward. After we have laid down the target of at least having from 2% to 10% of the space economy, this is being pushed by InSpace, and there is an Airwise Marshal who has been earmarked to push this forward. He is here with us during this conclave, and he will be telling you more about it. AVM Court, I am talking about you. Also, one important aspect is human capital for space, capacity development. And here is where, as more and more industry is growing, as the startups are growing, and as I see it, and I will just give you an example of, we saw Skyroot starting with 50 people, they have crossed 250. And similarly is the case with Agniku and many of our startups. A large number of talent is required for this. This will require more engineers to be trained in specific space verticals. And like space, you know, covers all these verticals. So this itself will become a requirement for the startups of the future. And finally, of course, support for generating global demand. Because if our startups are to be effective, they have not only to supply in India,
No, absolutely, valid points, sir. So again, the crux is that we have to focus both on the supply and the demand, testing infrastructure and all that. See, startup issues exist, right? So though we have come a long way, we have started supporting and creating all kind of requirements for the space startup. But still, as I said earlier, to scale, we need to up our game. We need to up our level so that more number of startups can come up and more scaling can happen, and we can work towards the scaling the ecosystem. Now, my next question goes to the approach that we are going to take in building up this thought leadership paper. Your thoughts on that?
So, I'll first start by just highlighting the approach that we follow for making policy recommendations. So, for any specific issue, we start by gathering inputs from relevant industry players. We get on one-on-one consultations with them to further understand the issue, and we do our own research and analysis on the topic. Now, all this ultimately leads up to continuous and close engagement with government ministries, relevant ministries. And we have been working with relevant government departments, including Ministry of Finance, MeitY, DPIIT, Department of Commerce, and so on specific issues which are relevant for startups. Now, some of these issues will also be applicable on space sector startups in that they are sector agnostic. So, taxation related issues or IPR related, intellectual property right related issues. also be applicable on startups. But when we are working towards identifying the specific areas of focus for space sector, I think the approach of developing our understanding as well as the approach to policy making will have to be collaborative, it will have to be iterative. Because the goal ultimately in that scenario would be to identify the right tools and the right incentives that should be provided to all the relevant stakeholders so that we can unlock the innovation capability that India currently possesses. And we have been working and following this similar approach on some of these issues in emerging sectors. For example, our work on patient capital for deep tech, where we are interacting again continuously with startups, with VC, with VCs, with relevant government ministries across different, to identify specific areas of focus across different stages of startup development or across different DRI levels. And I think this is why this collaboration with ISPA is especially relevant, because when we are planning on addressing the issues that sir also referred to, you need to have all these relevant stakeholders on board, and you need a collaborative and continuous approach in developing that understanding. And the presence of ISPA as the voice of Indian space industry is very helpful for us. And together, I think going forward, the goal of this whole exercise would be to take us towards the goal that is in front of us, right? Whether through the decadal vision that was shared, the idea of positioning Indian startup ecosystem on a global stage, all of this would ultimately require a collaborative approach, which we are looking for.
Absolutely, Dhananjay. So collaboration is the key. As we have seen from our experience in the other startup ecosystem also, collaboration is the key. And being Indian, we have Indian Space Association with us, who is standing at the forefront, leading this space charter. So I think, but yeah, going forward, I will just request everyone to please share your feedback, the views on what can we cover in this thought leadership paper. Please reach out to NASSCOM and ISPA to share your thoughts, what exactly we can cover and what kind of output you want to achieve from that, so that this thought leadership paper could be act as a Bible going forward whenever we talk about the space startup ecosystem. So with that, I would like to thank the panelists and thanks everyone for being here. Thank you.